Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about becoming an app expert. Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in on video number 348 from True Dreams, who said, "Hey Eric, I have a question. When can you call yourself an app developer expert? By the way, you have a big app. Don't you think you are an app developer expert? By the way, I am not." Waiting for the answer. You know what? I don't consider myself an expert on app development or anything really, because there's so many different facets of it, right? And it's kind of one of these things where I don't trust anyone who calls themselves an expert, right? If I ever like looking at CVs and stuff like that, I see I'm a mobile expert, right? I totally don't agree with that. An expert stops learning new things, right? This is my whole thing, right? If you get really good at app development or app marketing, whatever, there's so many different facets to it to begin with, right? So you could be like really good as an Android developer or an iOS developer in Kotlin or Swift or any of the other languages that are out there, right? But you might not know a lot about the marketing side or the, you know, how to deploy it live and all this kind of stuff, right? So there's all these different facets and it's always changing and it's always moving. And if you get really good at something, what you start to realize is how much more you don't know, right? And this is the same with everything I've ever done in technology. It's very difficult to call yourself an expert. I've had other people call me experts, not as an app developer, but like in other things. I can remember working at an investment bank, ever said, "Eric's our Access database expert," or "Eric's our SharePoint expert," or whatever. And I'm like, stop calling me expert, because there's so much there that I don't know, right? I mean, but you know, it's kind of in the eye of the beholder, right? I will never consider myself an expert, because you know what? An expert stops learning new things. An expert stops reading all the books and try to pick up on all the stuff, trying to improve what they do. I can remember once, and I talked about this before, where I would work at this investment bank and I carry these big books in with me. So I was reading this book on ASP.NET 2, Professional ASP.NET 2 by Rocks. This was a while ago, right? And I was carrying this into work and I was reading this because we were using still classic ASP. And someone said to me, "Aren't you afraid that people think you don't know what you're doing because you're reading the book?" And I said, "You know what? I don't know what I'm doing." You always have to improve, and you'd always learn something new from these kind of things. I mean, it's difficult to go back through and read the beginners. Like, you don't want to go read beginner's Android if you've already been through all those steps. You know, the history of Android, where we are from here, all that. They all start the same way, right? But you always want to be improving and getting better at it. And you know, I will never call myself an app developer expert, because as soon as I do, there's going to be somebody out there that says, "Oh yeah, well how do you do an interface?" They'll talk about something that's really specific, and we're all really good at different areas of what we do, right? And you know, and that's just my thinking, right? I don't trust people who call themselves experts, right? Because that means they stop learning. They stop seeing themselves as students and they start seeing themselves as the expert. But that's just my opinion. What do you guys think, right? What do you think? Do you have any problem calling yourself an expert at anything? So anyway, those are my thoughts for today. That's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.